Hello friends, this is Shubham and today I'm going to talk about a very important topic, that is fetal circulation, which means the blood circulation in the fetus. So what happens in fetal circulation? First of all, before understanding this concept of fetal circulation, we should know very well about our adult circulation, that is our circulation. What happens in our circulation? That we very well know that we have inferior vena cava and the superior vena cava, which is further draining into the right atrium on the right side of our heart or the right heart. So what happens in adult circulation? Inferior vena cava and the superior vena cava are draining into the right atrium. For example, this is our heart for a while. So this is the right atrium. Okay, this is the left atrium, this is the left ventricle, and this is the right ventricle. So what happens in adult circulation? I'm going to talk about that right now. So superior vena cava from the upper side and the inferior vena cava from the lower side, both these veins drain into the right atrium. From there, blood goes into the right ventricle, because this is the right ventricle, just beneath the right atrium, with the help of valves, with the help of tricuspid valve. So from the right ventricle, it goes into the pulmonary artery. So from the right ventricle, it goes into the pulmonary artery. Here, for example, this is the pulmonary artery going both sides into our lungs, two lungs. So the, and this is the, remember, this is the deoxygenated blood. So deoxygenated blood, first of all, comes through superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, comes into the right atrium. From there, it comes into the right ventricle. From right ventricle, it goes into the pulmonary circulation, pulmonary arteries. And they take this deoxygenated blood into the lungs. From there, blood converts into the deoxygenated blood converts into the oxygenated blood, because as we are inhaling the oxygen, so through the ventilation perfusion over there, the oxygenated blood will comes into the left atrium with the help of pulmonary veins. As the blood will comes into the left atrium, it will go into the left ventricle with the help of bicuspid or mitral valve. And from there, the left ventricle will contract and the blood, our oxygenated blood, will goes into the aorta, and aorta will supply the blood in all our body or in our whole body. So this was our adult circulation. Just a recap about the adult circulation before discussing about the, or before understanding about the fetal circulation. So let's now talk about the fetal circulation. What happens in fetal circulation? As it is very important to understand, because fetal circulation is not the same as an adult circulation, because the lungs are not open into the in the fetus, because lung because the fetus is not inspiring the oxygen, because as it is in the womb of the mother, so it is taking their nutrient from the placenta with the help of umbilical cord in the womb from the mother. So what happens in fetal circulation? Let's talk about that. This is the placenta of the mother over here. So this is the placenta I have drawn over here. This is the placenta. From the placenta, umbilical cord is going from the placenta into the fetus. So umbilical cord is basically connecting the placenta to the fetus. So umbilical cord is connecting the placenta with the fetus. So this is the fetus, overview of the fetus. Here I have drawn the heart of the fetus, the lungs of the fetus, which are not working in the fetus. I will talk about that. And this is the liver, for example, of the fetus. So what happens from where it starts, the fetal circulation in our fetus? There are actually one umbilical vein and two umbilical arteries. So umbilical vein, which I have drawn with the red color. So this is the umbilical vein. This is the umbilical vein. Remember, umbilical vein is only one. And the umbilical arteries, these are the umbilical arteries. Umbilical arteries are two in number. Umbilical arteries, these are two in number. So umbilical vein is carrying the oxygenated blood from the placenta to the fetus through the umbilical cord, with the help of the umbilical cord, of course. So umbilical vein, one umbilical vein is carrying the blood from the placenta to the fetus, and there it goes into the liver of the fetus. And what happens over there? It goes into the special channel. However, there are sinusoids also. Very little blood will drain into the sinusoids, and rest of the blood will goes into the ductus venosus in the liver. So for example, this is the channel, this is something, the channel which we named as ductus venosus. As the blood will comes from the placenta to the fetus, it will go into the liver first of all, and from, and in there, in the liver of the fetus, there is a ductus venosus channel through which the blood passes of the fetus. So for example, this is the ductus venosus over here, ductus venosus in liver. So the blood will goes through the ductus venosus and will mix into the inferior vena cava. For example, this is the inferior vena cava, which is draining into the right atrium, as we know very well. So what happens from the placenta? Umbilical vein is carrying the deoxygenated blood. This is about 80% of the blood is oxygenated, through which it goes. Once it reaches the fetus, it will go into the liver, into the special channel, that is ductus venosus. From ductus venosus, it will drain into the inferior vena cava, which is further draining into the right atrium. From there, right atrium, what is the special thing in the fetus heart? Actually, some of the blood will go into the right ventricle, as in the adults, as in us. But there is one foramen present over there in the right atrium, or near the right atrium, and that is called as foramen ovale, which is helping this oxygenated blood, which is further will be oxygenated and deoxygenated also, because the inferior vena cava is carrying the deoxygenated blood. So this blood is mixing with the inferior vena cava blood and finally draining into the right atrium. However, it is somewhat oxygenated. It will go, some blood will drain into the right ventricle, but from the right atrium, it will directly go into the left atrium, from the right ventricle to the left atrium. So the foramen ovale is helping the blood to bypass the pulmonary circulation. How? And it is causing the right to left shunt, because the right atrium, it is allowing the blood from the right side, from the right atrium to the left side, that is the left atrium. So it is allowing to bypass the pulmonary circulation. Because what will happen actually in us, because we don't have foramen ovale, actually after the birth, foramen ovale disappears and converts into ligaments, and in 1 or 2 months it closes automatically, because as we are getting the help of the oxygen, so pulmonary circulation is present in us. So what is happening, as the blood will come into the right atrium, some of the blood will of course go into the right ventricle, but most of it goes through this foramen, that is foramen ovale. So this foramen is named as the foramen ovale. Let me write over here, foramen ovale. So this is the foramen ovale. So the blood will goes from the right atrium to the right, sorry, to the left atrium through this foramen. And from there, as the blood will reach into the left atrium, it will come into the left ventricle with the help of the valves, bicuspid or mitral valve, and further it will go into the aorta, and from there it goes into the body. Okay? And whatever blood was coming into the right ventricle, whatever blood was coming into the right ventricle, it will go into the pulmonary circulation through the pulmonary artery. But as the lungs are not functioning in the fetus, these pulmonary arteries are very constricting. So they are not allowing, or they are allowing very little blood goes into the lungs, because the lungs are not functioning in the fetus. So what happens? The backflow of the blood in the pulmonary artery happens, and here one more foramen or one more entry is over there, and that is called as the ductus arteriosus. Ductus arteriosus. And what is the function of this, or what is the significance of this foramen or this duct, ductus arteriosus? This is allowing whatever blood is coming into the pulmonary artery through this hole, because the pulmonary artery is in very close contact with the aorta. So this hole is allowing the blood to reach into direct, to reach directly into the aorta. So what happens? That whatever blood will come, for example, whatever blood will come into this, so first of all, the blood will come into the right atrium. From right atrium, it goes into the right ventricle. Whatever blood is going to the right ventricle, it will go into the pulmonary circulation through the pulmonary artery, into the lungs, for example, like this. From there, it will backflow, and whatever blood is coming into the pulmonary arteries, through the ductus arteriosus, they will enter inside the aorta, and from there, aorta will pump the blood in all our body, in the fetus. And whatever blood was going from the foramen ovale, from the right atrium to the right, to the left atrium, that is causing the right to left shunt. So the foramen ovale is causing the right to left shunt. Right to left shunt. As it is bypassing the pulmonary circulation in the fetus. So these are two important things, that is for foramen ovale and the ductus arteriosus, which is helping the fetus, which is helping the fetus in the blood circulation. And this is about the, that how the fetus is carrying the oxygen to the tissues, to its tissues. So this is the mechanism, but how is it draining? What is the significance of these umbilical arteries? That is very simple. That is very simple. These are two umbilical arteries. So as the aorta, so this is the inferior vena cava. Let me name them. This is the inferior vena cava. And this is the, with the right, this is the aorta. So this is the aorta. So with the aorta, with the help of the aorta, the blood is going into the whole body, into the tissues. So the oxygenated blood is going into the tissues, and the deoxygenated blood from the aorta, there are two umbilical arteries which will carry the deoxygenated blood from the body and will drain back into the, through the umbilical cord, into the placenta. And what is happening inside the placenta? That, for example, this is the mother site, mother circulation, for example, and this is the fetal circulation. So what happens, that the mother is giving the oxygen towards the fetus side, and the fetus is giving the carbon dioxide. So this is the umbilical arteries, for example, these are the umbilical arteries coming over here, two umbilical arteries. Two umbilical arteries will give the, or will pass the carbon dioxide to the mother side in the placenta, and umbilical veins will carry the oxygen from the mother side to the fetus with the help of the umbilical vein, which is the one umbilical vein. So this was about the general circulation, fetal circulation, and how the fetus is getting the oxygenated blood and carrying the oxygenated blood to its tissues and draining the deoxygenated blood back to the mother side in the placenta. So this was the overview of the fetal circulation. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching.